This is Eric Fine of 72PC. Welcome to another week of Quick Hits. This week, we have some changes to Rocket League rank structure and a lot of Mario 35th anniversary news. But first, let's get into what I'm excited about this week. What I'm excited about this week actually just launched today. That's Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 and 2 Remake. Tony Hawk has always been known for the music, but the first and second entries into this series has an iconic lineup of songs that has stuck with a generation of kids all the way through adulthood. While this is a remake and does look way better than what it did back on the PlayStation and Nintendo 64, it does still feel the same from all accounts. All the hidden collectibles in this game are exactly where they were in the originals. All the letters, all the cassettes, all the bums, they're exactly where they were. So if you were a kid that spent hours upon hours grinding through this game, you probably remember exactly where this stuff is. They have made a few nice updates to the game though. Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2 added additional challenges to levels to give you more to do per level. That was missing from the first entry. Well, they went and added those style of challenges into the original Tony Hawk Pro Skater 1 levels. This adds a little more depth to the game and just gives you a little more time to focus on things inside the levels. But honestly, what I'm probably most excited about is the park editor. I love the park editor in the old Tony Hawk games. One didn't have it, but two introduced it, and three I felt was even the best. But you are getting a park editor in this, and they are allowing you to share maps. I think it'll be really cool to see what people end up making on this. I can see it being very Mario Maker-esque, where you end up having very long grind rail levels to see who can actually get through it, and different things like that. So if you get this game, be creative, make some maps, put them up there for everyone to enjoy. But enough about what I'm excited about. Let's move on to some news that a lot of people around the 72PC community has been talking about, and that is the change to the rank structure of Rocket League coming into the next season. While this update did have other news with it as well, the big takeaway for many Rocket League players, especially in the higher end of the spectrum, was that GC, or Grand Champion, is no longer going to be the top title in the game. They are in fact adding three divisions of Grand Champion, Grand Champ 1, 2, and 3, and then a new top tier rank that, I mean, let's be honest, the name's cheesy as hell. Supersonic Legend. If you think I'm joking and they wouldn't do anything that cheesy, no, it really is Supersonic Legend. You can go to the update page and find it. So we don't know where in the MMR spectrum it's going to lie. I personally think it'll probably be somewhere in the 19 to 2000 MMR range, something that personally I'm never going to get to. But it would be in there in the top 500 range of players, so it could be a nice little title for the top of the top. There was also some other news in this update. The Merc's getting its own hitbox. I'm not sure how I feel about this. On one hand, I like getting more hitboxes so you stop seeing the Octane meta. Maybe you might find some other cars that line up really well with the hitbox that has some nice power to it, but we'll see how this ends up playing out. Another thing they announced was the seasons are going to start lining up. What I mean by that is you have two different seasons that most players have to deal with. You have your Battle Pass season, you have your Rank season. They have officially announced that both of these seasons will coincide and start and end at the same exact time. Something that is probably important for a lot of players as well, as there will be a soft reset. They are trying to bring lower level players up to at least gold rank. That way, when the new players come into the game when it's free to play, there'll be a little room at the bottom for them to learn how to play without dealing with people who actually know the game. It's a good move on them to protect the new players coming in, but let's hope that it doesn't impact too much on the high end where you get GCs going against Diamond 3s. That's all we got for you this week on Rocket League. Let's move on to a big announcement that happened yesterday. And that is a Nintendo Direct for the 35th anniversary of the Super Mario Brothers. There was a lot of really, really cool news that came out of this. Personally, I'm very excited about a lot of this. Let's start with what might be viewed as the oldest of the news, and that is Super Mario All-Stars, a title originally released on the SNES that combined Super Mario 1, 2, 3, and Lost Levels, which is the more spiritual 2 than the actual 2. This compilation has been updated graphically and is being released to the SNES console on the Switch. I know that's a really convoluted statement, but what this means is the Switch has an SNES emulator and the All-Stars is being ported over to that. So it's updated, it looks beautiful, it requires a Nintendo Online subscription, but if you have that, the game's there for you right now. Also on the All-Star front, they're making a brand new All-Stars game. They're calling it Super Mario 3D All-Stars. And this is the one that I'm super excited about. It's going to include Super Mario 64, Super Mario Sunshine, and Super Mario Galaxy. Personally, I've never played Sunshine, so I'm pretty excited to be able to pick up this bundle, play back through Mario 64, which a lot of us just loved growing up, and being able to play Sunshine some. And as well as anyone who's never played Galaxy, the systems and how they work, that game was great. So if this is going to be your first exposure to Galaxy, you will enjoy this. This is a great game. Some strange news that they released that actually seems like it could be interesting. For those of you that are familiar with a game called Tetris 99 on the Switch, it's a battle Tetris game where as you eliminate lines, you drop more pieces on your opponents to be the last man standing. It's a Tetris battle royale per se. Well, Nintendo decided why not give one for Mario. So they are creating a game called Super Mario 35. This is a Mario battle royale, but please look it up and don't just think this is PUBG with Mario, because that's not what this game is. Effectively, you're playing through Super Mario, and as you kill an enemy, it doesn't just disappear from your screen, it reappears on an opponent's screen. And the idea is to keep killing these monsters and have them show up on your opponent's screen and eventually kill them. The goal? Be the last Mario standing. It's a pretty simple concept, but it gets really fun because there's strategies on where your monsters go when you kill them. You can have it randomly put it to someone. You can have it just go to someone who is doing the best. And there's also this concept they're calling an item roulette, where you randomly get power-ups. Not sure quite how that works, but I am really excited to play this game. Once again, requires a Nintendo Online subscription and will only be available for a limited time. It sounded like they were pulling this sometime in March. Just get out there, play it while you can. It seems like it could be a really good time. Some non-Mario Mario news. They're actually adding a Mario Splatfest into Splatoon, as well as letting you play with some Mario items in Splatoon. Not sure how this is going to work out, but if you're still in that Splatoon 2 grind, I want to check these modes out as they get available. Could be fun. Could suck. Who knows? Try it out. Let us know what you guys think. And the final bit of news we're going to get onto about this Direct is a really interesting thing they're doing with Mario Kart. Might be gimmicky, might be stupid, but it is interesting. So they are doing an augmented reality version of Mario Kart where you're playing on your Switch and you're controlling an RC car on a track in your actual house. So your car will go through these flags that you set up on your house to kind of dictate the boundaries of the course. And then it seems like the Mario Kart game is going to generate a course between those flags, and you're going to drive a remote control car in real life through the course that you're going to see on your Switch. I'm not sure how well it's going to get executed, but this could be really fun for a couple tries. Not sure it's something I'll go out and buy, but if a friend of mine has it, I'm going to sneak over to his house and play it. Well, that's all we got for the Mario front. It's really all we got for the news front this week. So we're just going to get you out of here on what I'm thinking is the deal of the week. And it is kind of also a news item. So Steam has introduced a subscription service. It's not theirs. EA Play. This is the old EA Access program. It is now available on Steam. It is $5 a month to play and you get access to the EA library. They have a lot of games outside of sports games. So there's some really fun ones out there. Personally, I really love Peggle, even though it's a little arcade game, but you have titles like Titanfall 2. You've got some other nice stuff like Mirror's Edge if you never played that back in the 360 era. But either way, $5 a month. You know, it's kind of a tag you may not want to pay, but if you do a year up front, it is only $30 for an entire year and you have access to the EA library. If you're not a sports fan, I promise the $30 for a year, you will find games you like. You will. If you are a sports fan, hell, it's half price Madden. Go play it. Well, that's all we got for you guys this week on Quick Hits. So, till next week, game on.